The following section provides some typical examples of the way in which the machinery of propaganda is used. See if you can sort out the emotionally charged words that are intended to arouse the listener to action.
Let us turn to the communist program. The target they are working towards, the batting of communism, is a society of eternal peace between nations, freedom for all nations, universal well-being and prosperity for the people of the earth. What could be more patriotic than fighting for the happiness of one's people? That is a fair appraisal, with which it is impossible not to agree.
Yes, what is more patriotic than fighting for one's own people, whether they be capitalist, socialist, communist, or whatever? Blood is thicker than vodka.
No matter how hard the reactionary bourgeois propaganda machine tries to minimize the Soviet Union's decisive role in the struggle against German fascism, these events are another reminder that militarist groups in the West have not abandoned their schemes and that the people must not relax their vigilance in relation to those who have learned nothing from the lessons of the past war. The decisive factor that is restraining the aggressive forces in their desire to unleash war is the increased power of the USSR and the other socialist countries. The time has passed when adventures launched by imperialists could go by unpunished.
True, nor will aggression in any other camp go unpunished.
You can be sure that if the United States and Britain really wanted an agreement to stop nuclear tests for all time, they could find the arguments for it and convince their NATO ally friends to stop its experiments in this era. Since they do not, it only shows again that they do not desire any such agreement. The blame lies chiefly with the United States, which pursues a policy of obstruction and red tape. In Laos, the voice of Tetet Lao commented that the Soviet Union's lucid and constructive proposals reveal that the USSR invariably abides by the principles of peaceful coexistence and the right for all nations to decide their own home and foreign affairs.
It seems most illogical in these times to speak of all nations deciding their own home and foreign affairs regardless of the rest of the world. No decision fails to affect other countries.
Marshal Semyon Timoshenko noted that the chief burden in the war against the fascist invaders fell to the Soviet Union. The victory, he said, was determined on the Soviet fronts.
Russia alone could never have survived. Remember the Murmansk run?
The principle used by reactionary Western propaganda in writing about the socialist countries is charge others with what you yourselves are doing. But fewer people are to be found every day who believe these inventions of the capitalist propaganda machine. People everywhere know that the Soviet Union is a land of peace.
Most folks are inclined to accept things like politics at face value. Independent thinking is rare. But in our own free world, we hold and treasure the freedom to think and disagree. Can we have this freedom and then not use it?
The governments of the Western powers will be taking on themselves a great responsibility before the peoples of their countries if they only reply with maneuvers and subterfuges to the clear, resilient, and high-minded Soviet position.
Some of my best friends and worst enemies are clear, resilient, and high-minded.
The Soviet Union honestly abides by its obligations not to experiment with nuclear arms. This is an honest proposal, permeated with a sincere desire for mutual understanding.
Time and again, the Soviet Union has given convincing proof that it is ready to light not only a small candle, but a big bonfire of friendship and mutual understanding.
Upright people everywhere wish Mr. Khrushchev, that tireless fighter for peace, success in his mission.